Well, we started giving you some of our gifts.
You've got your my garden gloves.
$3.95 we spent on that.
That's very nice.
And I don't think you all know this, but Linda's husband, Will, who's one of the fine, fine professors at OU, is also retiring.
He's taught some 40,000 kids
Amazing.
Down there.
After 40 years that he's done that, so they're going to be spending more time together. Mm-hmm. So I got you these earplugs. you know what? Actually, these are for Will.
They need to go to him.
Yeah, they're for Will.
That poor man. I feel so sorry for him. I'll put this right here in my glove.
So he does. And also, earlier today, a lot of our folks were out gathering the news, but we had some 60 people here. I took a picture with Linda, and we'll show you the full screen of it here. There it is right there. Thank you, Linda. And we had a great time. This is when they dedicated the studio to you, and we all kind of got together, those of us who could, and said, good luck.
Oh, what an honor that was. Totally surprised, but so grateful. So very nice. You know, for the past 40 years, you've shown me nothing but kindness, but the last month has been extraordinary. You showered me with cards, chocolates, and flowers, which I appreciate more than you can imagine. But you also gifted me with your words. They were loving, encouraging, supportive. I'll carry them in my heart for years to come. And you've made a difference in my life. I'm a better person for having known you. Because through telling your stories, you taught me courage. I remember victims of the bombing facing years of recovery, but facing each day with gratitude and determination. And I've learned about compassion firsthand, time after time. I've seen you respond after terrible tornadoes. You treat strangers in need as though they're your neighbors. And quite frankly, you're like family. We've had our children together. We've comforted each other during losses. You were there as we grieved my friends and colleagues, Brad Edwards, Bob Berry Jr. Our bonds are strong, and I'm grateful to you. And I'm thankful for my friends here at Channel 4 who've shared their extraordinary abilities with me for four decades. Any spotlight you perceived was focused on me was merely a reflection of the talents of those around me. I've been surrounded by men and women who excel at what they do, producers, photographers, engineers, writers. I'm grateful that they allowed me to learn from them. And most importantly, I'm grateful to my family, my husband of almost 43 years, who's going to use these earplugs, Will and our two children, Paul and Ann. They're the world to me. And some wonder, why leave now? Well, simply because it feels right. 40 years is a nice round number. And I know there's someone who can step in and continue the tradition of excellence for which the station is known. Jolene Chaney is ready. Well, what will I miss? I'll miss you. I'll miss my daily laughs and conversation with my station colleagues, but I'm looking forward to the unknown. It's like being in the middle of a mystery novel and wanting to see what comes next. Whatever it is, I'll never forget my Oklahoma roots, the red clay that stains my soil and the wind that never stops. And I'll never forget the wonderful years you've allowed me to spend with you. Thank you.
My friend, this is our final four shot together. This has been amazing to sit next to. I've learned so much from her. And we just want to one last time say thank you.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate you all. Thank you very much.
And I'll go ahead and say it. Friday Sports Overtime is coming up next.